Welcome to the Sphere of Grace. I'm Pastor Ngobaje. Thank you for tuning in, and God bless you. Today we're looking at the word of faith from Romans chapter 10. We'll start reading from verse 8. It says, "But what said it? The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thine heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shall believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved." And verse 10 tells us, it says, "For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation." Glory to God. So you see, the word of faith here is the word of God. And how does it work? The word of faith works through preaching. The word of faith is preached. Now, how do you preach it? You preach it with your mouth. You don't only preach it to sinners who need to be saved. That same word of faith is preached to your body, is preached to your health, is preached to your marriage, is preached to everything that needs to hear God's word in your life. So you preach it with your mouth through confession. It says, "If thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus." So that means the word of faith confesses the Lordship of Jesus over situations and circumstances, over everything. Glory to God. It does not matter how long that thing has been out of place. When you begin to confess and address that situation with the word of faith, you speak confessing the Lordship of Jesus over that thing. So that's why the word of faith is authoritative. You speak authoritatively, commanding that thing to bow to the Lordship of Jesus Christ. It says, "If thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God had raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved." It shows us two things here. Number one, the confession of your mouth as to the Lordship of Jesus Christ. And then number two, the conviction in your heart as to what God has already done in raising Jesus Christ from the dead. What does that mean? It means the word of faith is based on realities, settled realities in God's word. What God has concluded, what God has done. Your heart has come to accept and believe that God has raised Jesus from the dead. God has blessed you. God has made you whole. God has increased you. God has moved you forward. God has done it. Listen, known unto God are all his works from the beginning of the world. So you know in your heart that God has done it. How? Through revelation. The spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, showing you what God has done. How that when he finished his works, the Bible says he rested from his works, and he sanctified the seventh day and blessed it, and he called it the Sabbath. The word of faith is the word that is spoken from the rest of God, that God has concluded it, and so I rest in him. It comes by revelation. And when the revelation of God's word comes to you, you begin to speak from your mouth, or with your mouth rather, that which God has done, and you believe in your heart that is settled. And then you see the physical manifestation of it. This is the word of faith. Your heart is involved in processing the word of God in revelation, and you are convinced that it is done. Your mouth is involved in declaring what has been done, and then salvation is the result. Glory to God. For with the mouth, the Bible says, we confess, our salvation unto salvation. With our heart, we believe unto righteousness. Praise God. Hallelujah. I believe you've been blessed today. Go ahead and engage the word of faith. And as you do, you get awesome results in your life in Jesus' name. God bless you.